Now I want to talk about taking your company fully Google. Why it's great for your business to be completely Googlified in everything that you do. Now, if you're already a Workspace customer, it would make good sense for you to get the most out of your investment and use all of the Google tools as much as possible to get the most for your business. But there's also some pretty cool advantages to making sure that when everything is Google, you get the most streamlined experience. And myself personally, being a minimalist, I like having everything in one place. So I'm going to take you through some of the key things that you can do to really Googlify your business and, in a way, Googlify your life to get things working nice and smoothly and get them as tightly integrated as possible. Now, the biggest mistake that I make, the biggest mistake that I see many business owners making is that when they set up their Apple phone for their Google account, they actually use Apple's mail program. Now, this is a big no-no because you're missing out on a lot of the best features inside of Gmail. Not only does Gmail have the ability to search back past the last 30 days, you can search through all of your email and you can do all of the advanced searching that you would have seen in other videos of ours, but you can also take advantage of the archiving feature. There's also the snooze feature, and Google have the automated AI-based automated responses for your emails. So you may have seen them if you've used Gmail in the Gmail app. It actually automatically can compose emails for you. Well, all of that is exclusive to the Gmail app, so you want to make sure that you're using the Gmail app for absolutely everything. Now, personally, I leave my notifications off for both of these applications. I just leave all my app notifications switched off, and I only access my email when I want to. But when you are inside your Gmail, you'll be able to have access to your full Gmail list of emails, literally every single one. Cool, got that one? Make sure you get that right. Now, next up, switching to a work profile on your mobile. Now, this is not quite available on Apple devices, but it is available on Android devices. You can actually switch on a work profile, which means that you can have two copies of Gmail on your phone. Now, when you have a second copy of Gmail on your phone, what that actually means is that you can have a personal Google account and a business Google account. Now, why would we want to do that? Well, because Friday at 5 p.m., I'm no longer interested in reading any of my business emails. If there is something urgent, someone will call one of our managers and they have the ability to get in touch with me if any of my work issues have been escalated and it's an absolute emergency after hours. However, from time to time, I still want to receive personal emails and I still want to be able to deal with things over the weekend from my personal mailbox. And so my strong recommendation is that you actually separate your business and your personal email and you have them as two separate accounts. Now, we've got a dedicated video on this if you're interested in setting up a secondary Google Workspace account just for your personal data. I go through all the pros and cons and you can check out that video on our YouTube channel. And that takes you through what it's like to set up a second Google account, a second Google Cloud account, just for all your personal data. And you can use like a family Google Workspace account for all your photos, for all your files, and everything in your digital world. But what I want to drill in here for you is having those two email accounts separate and being able to work on them separately allows you to actually have a clear delineation between what is your personal stuff and then what is your business stuff. And so setting up the two different addresses means that if you ever were to exit the business or sell your business, all of your stuff is not necessarily tied to your business account. And I would be doing things like signing up for insurances, personal newsletters, personal shopping, your eBay or your Amazon account, things like, signing up for, newsletters that you want for your personal life. All that stuff should be done on your personal account rather than your business account. Your business account should just be your business stuff. Next up, once you have the Gmail account set up on your phone, well, inside, you can launch a meeting straight from within Gmail. Now, this works excellent on the mobile. You can click one button, launch a meeting, and send that straight over to someone. But what I love is Google have actually also put this inside of our Gmail as well. So you can see here, I need to minimize my chat. You can see Google Meet here. I can click a button and immediately launch a new meeting. I just grab the invitation. I can even cut and paste it there with one little clip, and I can send that on to anyone. Now, some of the advantages of using Google Meet over Zoom are that you only need a browser. You don't need to download anything. It's nice and simple to use. And if you're on a business standard plan on Google Workspace, you can even automatically record your meetings and have them go straight into your Google Drive, which I absolutely love. Great, great little feature there. Next up is the ability to chat within Gmail. You've probably already seen this, but if you've not already made access to this or made use of this, or maybe you're still using Slack for your chat You can see here that all of our conversations within our business can all happen right within our Gmail. Now, we've got all kinds of chats and we've got other videos on how we use chat inside our business and you know, why we believe it's useful and why we believe everyone should be using it. This is our water cooler that we use for just like our general kind of chit chat that the team share stuff with day to day. And basically inside here, I can keep connected with my team right from within my Gmail. And so Google's basically taken all of their tools and kind of built them into Gmail. You can see on the right-hand side here, I've even got my calendar for the day, so I can see everything that's going on there. And Google want Gmail to be your one single workplace for everything that's going on. And so if I've got access to everything here, why would I use an external tool like Zoom for my meetings? Why would I use an external tool like Slack for my chat? Why would I use, I don't know, something else for my notes like Evernote? I don't know if anyone still uses Evernote anymore. But having everything in one place makes my life a lot more streamlined. And it also means that I only have to have one tab open to access pretty much everything communication and collaboration-wise with myself and the rest of my team. So I spoke a little earlier about having a personal email account and using that email account for your own personal mail. Now, some people still have old email accounts that are hanging around, like a BigPond account or you know, maybe a personal Gmail account that you're still using for business, or maybe you've got a Hotmail account and there's legacy emails still going there. And for any of those accounts that are not currently in the Google ecosystem, you may not be getting the most efficient use out of them. Let's just say that the ergonomics and the experience, the user experience of some of the online apps are not excellent. And so what my preference is to actually migrate all of that historical email into Google. So our team, through a migration process, will actually pick up all of that email and migrate it into your Google account, whether it be your business account or maybe your personal account. And then from there, we actually use something called the Mail Fetcher to bring those emails into your Google account for each new email that arrives. So these are inside, you can see in the account settings, you can add a mail account. And what that actually does is it checks mail and sucks in mail from other accounts. So if you've got a Hotmail account lying around or you've got an old Gmail account and it's got business data in it and you want to merge those in, if you're interested in a professional services assistance with actually getting the email merge done so you don't have to spend time dicking around doing it yourself, have a chat to our team about our concierge program where we can help with email migrations between different Google accounts. But then after that's done, you can use the Mail Fetcher to actually go and receive, drag those emails into your Google account and download them so they're all in one place inside of Google. I personally like having all of my data inside Google because I trust them more than any other third parties. And so for that reason, I like bringing all of that in. This message is for those of you still using Outlook or still using Mac Mail who have a Google account and are refusing to use Gmail. And this is the age-old question of should I use Outlook or Mac Mail on my local computer versus using Gmail? And before I jump straight into, you know, why the search is better and the other bits and pieces, I want to take you on a little bit of a rundown memory lane. I want you to think about the first time that you got yourself an email address. And for me, I was in primary school. It was in the mid to late 90s. And I had a Mbox account, which was an Australian company that did email, and my friends were able to send me email. And what happened was that as my friends sent me email, my mailbox would start to fill up, right? And if someone sent me too many cat videos or too many forward chains saying, if you don't forward this, you'll have bad sex for 7 years, then what would happen is my mailbox would be full and my friends would start getting bounce backs. And basically, we've never dropped the habit of trying to keep our mailboxes clean and tidy because we're worried about running out of storage space. Now, what happened is, over time, our mailboxes got bigger and bigger and bigger. And we went from having a limit of about 5 megabytes on that pop mailbox, and we started downloading those emails to our computer, right? And when we downloaded them to our computer, they would no longer exist on the server. They would just exist on our computer. And basically, Outlook, and we'll talk about Exchange in a moment, but Mac Mail as well, would download these emails down to your computer, and that's where all of your emails would sit. And that worked fine because it cleaned up the server, and it worked fine because all your emails were kind of like sitting there on the actual local computer. But what it didn't work great for was search, because after a while, you'd get 5 or 10,000 emails sitting inside there, and you'd have 10 gigabytes or 15 gigabytes or 20 gigabytes, and all of a sudden, search starts running slow, performance crashes, and if you lose or break your computer and you haven't backed up the local computer, poof, all of those emails are gone. Now, I've lost data before. Most of us have lost data in some way or another in our lives. It is not a great feeling, particularly when you're a business owner and someone might sue you or the tax department might come after you, and you need to have a copy of every single email that you own and that you have. And so different solutions came along, like Microsoft Exchange and MacMail can connect to Google and like synchronize back and forward. And so the emails are still kind of on Google. But the problem is that as business owners, when we keep every single email because we need to make sure that we don't run into trouble by losing an email, well, those mailboxes get pretty full up. And I know that after 12 years myself, I have 500,000 emails sitting in my inbox. It's absolutely out of control. And my local computer literally wouldn't have enough space to be able to access all of those if I was to access it. Now, when I jump into my Gmail, all of my emails are sitting inside my Gmail. And if I show you exactly how much I've got in here, let me open it up. So you can see here, I'm in my emails. I have 55, nearly 56 gigabytes of email. I have 500,000 emails in my inbox. Yet when I search for an email from 2010, bang, instantly they pop up. And this email from 2010 is actually called Best Positions in Bed, which sounds interesting. Let's have a look at what's in that. Ah, there we go. Lovely. Good old chainmail from 2010, blast from the past. So what that gives me the ability to do is access any one of my emails that I need to access, no matter how many emails I have inside my inbox. And so if you're still using emails on your local desktop, you're just absolutely nuts. And some people say, well, what about working offline? Well, Gmail now lets you work offline in the browser. It'll automatically synchronize the last 90 days of emails, all of your contacts. You've got the ability to compose, and you've basically got everything there for you to be able to work your Gmail from offline. So if you've not yet made the switch, now's the time to make the switch. If you want to fight me in the comments. I'll be there waiting to tell you that Gmail is the only way. If you're not yet a member of our group online, you can access our free group for business owners below. We have exclusive videos, live videos, and content before it hits our YouTube channel in there. And if you've not yet had a free consultation with our team, then it's probably a good idea to do a growth roadmap session. We will take you and your team through the journey of our growth roadmap, and we will share with you all the different stages of business. We'll identify where you're at, we'll look for any holes in anything that you've missed in your technology strategy, and we will point you in the right direction. Now, if you're a good fit for our concierge service, which is unlimited access to our consulting team and heaps of other perks, discounts on Google licenses and all kinds of other great goodies, then we will offer you to get in touch. But if you want to just transfer your licenses and transfer your billing to us, then you'll get access to our exclusive Google Classroom where we have free courses. Don't have to pay anything. Don't have to join concierge if you don't want to. We have free courses inside our Google Classroom, and if you've not yet got access to those, have a chat to our team and we will help you get access. If you're watching the repeat, let me know. Just do a hashtag repeat and drop it down in the comments there, and we will catch you guys in another future one. Thank you. I love you. Peace, and we'll see you guys soon. Cheers.